السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. اليوم راح نبدي الكونكتيف تيشو ديزيز اللي هي بارت اوف اوتو اميون ديزيز، اللي تشملنا الامراض اللي بها اعراض جلدية بالاضافة الى الاعراض الاخرى، مثلا اعراض جلدية وياها اعراض المفاصل، العضلات، الانترنال اورجان، ليفر، سبلين، كيدني، اندر سبيراتوري تراكت. كونكتيف تيشو ديزيز لايك روماتويد ارثرايتس، لوبس اريثماتوسس، دارماتومايوسايتس، سكليروديرما اور اوفرلاب. يوجوالي ات از ا جروب اوف مالتي سيستميك النص اوف ان نون اتيولوجي. اذا هي مالتي سيستميك سكن اند انترنال اورجان. دايجنوسيس ديبند اون كاركترستيك كلينيكال فايندينج. عندنا كلينيكال فايندينج سكن واضح اند distinct pattern of cellular and humoral immunity. The autoantibody to cell component typically nuclear antigen are present in this multi-system disorder. إذن الجسم يفرز autoantibody المن للنورمال antigen, normal cell component سواء nuclear or cytoplasmic or membranous. باللوبس اريثماتوسس أكثر شيء nuclear antigen. إذن عادة الاميونيتي ناتشرال اميونيتي او ذا بودي اوكي اتاك اونلي ذا انفيدر الفورين ماتيريال لايك فايرال بكتيريال باراسايت. لكن هنا عندنا بالكونكتيف تيشو ديزيز ذا سيل اند سيلولار اميونيتي اند هيومورال اميونيتي اتاك ذا نورمال سيل كومبوننت. اوكي اذا وي هاف اوتو antigen, we have antibody and bind to autoantigen that is present in the nuclei. Here we have autoantibody for a specific disease, so there is every autoantibody to specific anti to specific disease. Then when you have the scleroderma, systemic lupus erythematosus, we have specific antibody like systemic lupus erythematosus, what we write antinuclear, the Crest syndrome, centromere, واضح. Scleroderma, we have sclera 70. إذا عندنا polymyositis, we draw one antibody. So there is every disease there is a specific auto antibody. Like these pictures. إذن هاي التيبل لازم إحنا نحفظه. ونخليه عندنا حتى من يجينا suspected disease لازم نعرف عندنا specific auto antibody. هو مو نكتبها كلها لأي مريض، لا، هم expensive يعني and time consuming. So when we suspect dermatomyositis or systemic lupus erythematosus or systemic sclerosis, we must know what is the specific auto antigen. Lupus erythematosus اللي هو نسميه داء الذئب الاحمراري. Lupus erythematosus is a range of from purely cutaneous, أما purely cutaneous نسميه discoid cutaneous lupus erythematosus اللي have فقط skin finding with very mild internal finding to severe systemic lupus. ليس من systemic لأن involve skin and internal organs. عادة we have hereditary factor genetic susceptibilities and with exposure to the sunlight, artificial light, or exposure to a drug like patient intake hydralazine, procainamide, antihypertensive lead to the flaring of the disease or the appearance of the disease. So not every individual. So when there is genetic susceptibility, hereditary factors, and associated with something from the environment like stress or exposure to ultraviolet light or take some of the drugs lead to the appearance of the disease or a flaring or increase the severity of the disease. Presentation usually in women more than men, in the female and in the men the disease usually acute but sometime subacute or chronic, but usually it is acute in onset, not insidious. And the main presentation is the erythema of the cheek and nose in butterfly shape like butterfly يعني مثل جناح الفراشة on the cheek and the nose with facial swelling. The most important dermatological manifestation مثل ما قلنا اللي هو butterfly. Okay. In addition to periangual telangiectasia, erythema over the digit, hair fall, and photosensitivity, ulcers of the palate and tongue in the buccal mucosa. These are the most important dermatological manifestations. And the skin changes, usually amma transient, continuous, or recurrent, and usually correlated well with the activity of the systemic disease. So more severe disease, more skin manifestations. Like this picture, this is the butterfly. مثل ما تلاحظون, there is erythema, swelling with fine scale of the cheek and the tip of the nose, and increase with photo exposure. من يتعرض للشمس أو إلى ultraviolet light, lead to the exacerbation of the skin disease. With sparing of the nasolabial fold, مثل ما تشوفون, sparing perioral and perinasal and nasolabial and periorbital. Also the involvement of the back of the hand with sparing of the knuckles, that لاحظون النكلز over the joint, sparing not involved by the rash. This patient with photo exacerbated is non-proteic scaling eruptions مثل ما تلاحظون photo exposures. Acute SLE sometimes associated with internal manifestation like fever, arthritis, internal organ involvement. The most important internal organ involvement is renal. So when there is renal involvement, if good renal function is good prognosis. When bad or severe renal involvement, this means poor prognosis. This is the systemic manifestations. This is the most important organs involved. Complication, the disease by itself don't won't affect the skin, produces scarring or hyperpigmentation, but the danger when use of large dose of systemic steroid for long duration and from internal organ involvement. We have some a criteria to diagnose the disease. أول شيء اللي هو مالر رش اللي هي fixed erythema flat raised over the malar eminence, or discoid rash. Discoid rash characterized by thickening of skin with adherent scale and follicular flaking, and when healed, discoid rash leave atrophic scarring, especially in older lesion. Photosensitivity, the skin rash appear on just slight exposure to the sunlight, not like normal individual. With oral ulcer formation, and usually it is painless. Involvement of joints, especially the small joints, serocytes like pleurisy or pericarditis, renal disorder like persistent proteinuria, cellular cast, neurological disorders, hematological disorder, it is very important. We have hemolytic anemia, leukopenia, lymphopenia, and thrombocytopenia. So all the blood element will be decreased. So chronic anemia, leukopenia, lymphopenia, thrombocytopenia. An immunological disorder like anti-nuclear antibody and high titer, anti-SM antibody and antiphospholipid antibody. So every patient with SLE, we must do these three immunological disorder, anti-DNA, anti-SM and antiphospholipid antibody, because it is specific to SLE. In addition to any anti-nuclear antibody in abnormal high titer. So four of these criteria, four or more, it is compatible with the diagnosis of SLE. This patient in subacute SLE, مثل ما تلاحظون, plaque, well demarcated, scaly. Okay, very similar to psoriasis, sometimes very difficult to differentiate it from psoriasis. Treatment, أهم شيء is sunscreen. So photosensitivity should avoid sun exposure, and topical steroids when there is mild or limited skin involvement, we give topical corticosteroid. If not healed, we give intralesional corticosteroids. In large skin involvement, when there is severe skin involvement, we give antimalarial 200 milligram of hydroxychloroquine twice per day. It is the first choice in cutaneous in cutaneous lupus erythematosus. But the most important side effect in antimalarial, it should we do ophthalmological examination. يعني لازم نشيك العين because have side effect on the eye. Dapsone is alternative to antimalarial. Oral corticosteroid when disease with internal organ involvement and not respond to antimalarial, we give prednisolone 20 milligrams twice daily. Other treatment like azathioprine, methotrexate, and acitretin, chalcitine, we give when there is poor response to antimalarial and when we need give prednisolone steroid for long durations. الآن discoid lupus erythematosus اللي هو فقط involvement of skin with a very low incidence of systemic disease, sometimes associated with systemic involvement but it's very little but mainly in the skin involvement. اللي يميزنا discoid lupus erythematosus formation of scaly plaque with adherent scale with follicular involvement, involvement of the hair follicle, hyperkeratosis, and when heal leave scarring alopecia. واضح. Discoid lesions with adherent thick scale, hyperkeratotic, especially follicular plaquing. If not treated, leave to the atrophy, hypopigmentation or hyperpigmentation, skin atrophy, telangiectasia, and sometimes disfiguring. So must be treated very good. Like this picture, especially in dark. This is the healed lesions. When healed, leave atrophic, hypopigmented, white in color with telangiectasia. So it is disfiguring. So the skin lesion should be treated as early as possible. Investigation, we just do skin biopsy because autoantibody, there is absent of serum autoantibody. Treatment, topical corticosteroids or intralesional corticosteroid, and in the resistant cases we give oral antimalarial drug. Thank you very much.